This video will walk you through my new habit tracker hub and show you how you can use it to break your bad habits and build new ones. You can grab this dashboard through the first link in the description. Now let's get started. Alright, so let's start off with probably the coolest feature about this whole dashboard, the accountability partner. The only thing you need to do for this formula to work is just click inside of the database entry and type in your name at the top. And that's it. Inside of this formula, you'll notice it gives you a welcome message, which will read good morning, good day, or good evening, depending on the time of day, and then your name and text saying, here's a quick overview of your day so far. Now, because it's a new day, it's also saying that I don't have any tasks or habits yet. So let's go ahead and add some. What we want to do is click on this new week button to add each day of the week to our habit tracker. Then if we click inside of today's day of the week and scroll down, you'll notice a section with all of our habit buttons. Now the first change you need to make is edit the add week button by clicking the gear icon next to it and then just add in your current week. Once that's done, you can click on the first button to add today's date, which will make it show up on the accountability partner, and then you also want to add in your current week. Once you've added your week, it'll show the date range, so if you've added in the wrong week, then you can always just remove this relation and change the button to the correct one. And because your day is now linked to a week, if you click inside of the week view, you'll see your current week as well as the progress of your total, good and bad habits. And then your current week is also linked to a month, which is linked to a quarter, which is linked to a year, all showing the total progress of your habits. Now let's go back to our day and add in some habits. To add habits, we'll be using these buttons, but you'd first need to set up your own daily habits. So all you want to do is just edit your habit button and rename the existing habits, or click on the three-dot menu next to one of them and duplicate below. This will add another habit which already contains today's date and is linked to your current day, so all you need to do is just rename it to your new habit and then click done. And if you have specific habits for specific days, then you can just repeat this process with the seven buttons below. And this goes without saying, but you also want to do the exact same with all the bad habits that you want to stop. And just note that these buttons are all inside of a synced block, so you only need to make the change once and don't have to edit each individual template button. Though if for some reason the synced block doesn't load after duplicating the dashboard, then just go into your Monday template button, copy the synced block, and go into each of your template buttons and just paste it in. Then you should be good to go. Now that all of our habits are added to the buttons, we can click on them to add all of our daily habits. And as you'll see on the accountability partner, they will now show up and show the total progress. So if you go ahead and mark some of these as complete, you'll see the accountability partner updating. And if you add new habits, then just make sure to also go to your habit buttons on your dashboard and add the new habit button by just duplicating one of the existing buttons, renaming the button, giving it an icon, and then going into the button filters and just replacing the name with your new habit. Now if we click on this new button, you'll see it checking off the habit on the accountability partner. And because all of our good habits are complete, it will now show text that says, good job, you're slowly becoming the person you know you could be. And if we do it the other way around, where we still have good habits to complete, but our bad habits are done, then it'll show text that says, nice job, looks like you're stronger than your bad habits. And if we complete all of our habits, then this whole habit section will disappear, and we get text that says, well done, you're clearly disciplined and focused on improving your life, keep it up. Now also note that these buttons are also inside of sync blocks, which are added to the mobile habits page, which you can add as a widget to your phone so you can quickly check off your habits. Alright, so we've covered the habit tracker, now let's move on to the project and task management system. If you open up your day and scroll down, you'll see you have a daily task section with a task database filtered to today, so any tasks you add here will automatically have today's date, which will also make it show up on the accountability partner. We can also relate our tasks to a project, and then on the dashboard you'll be able to see your project's progress, as well as find a calendar that you can use to schedule both your tasks and projects. And then you also have a third view on the calendar that shows all of your days with their habit progress. Next up is the productivity journal. Inside of each day, you have a productivity journal that you can use to plan and reflect on the day. You have a section for the work and personal focus, which you'd fill out before starting the day to decide where you want to spend your time and energy. You have a notes section for, well, notes. You have a reflect section, which is for at the end of the day to determine why you had a productive day or not and the reasons for it. You have a section for the story-worthy moment, which is the highlight of your day, but written as if it's a story you're telling to a friend. Then you have a section for logging your daily energy levels and mood. And then at the bottom, you have a section for logging your daily productivity score, which will show up as a progress bar and be reflected across the week, month, quarter, and year, so you can try and beat your previous productivity score and see how productive you were throughout the year. Now for the weekly view. At the end of each week, you can go into that week's page and add in your ABC tasks for the following week. 8 tasks is your absolute tasks that you need to get done as quickly and effectively as possible. B tasks are your beneficial tasks, that's also important, but you can only start with them once your 8 tasks are finished. And then the C tasks are your can wait tasks, which are tasks that eventually needs to get done, but isn't important or urgent, so these can always be moved on to the next week. And then with these as well, you can only start with them once your B tasks are done. Inside the ABC tasks databases, you can also link them to a project and add their due dates, which will make them show up on your main dashboard calendar. Inside the same weekly page, if you scroll down past the ABC tasks, you'll see a weekly review that you can fill out at the end of each week, and the same goes for the months, quarters, and years. This helps you reflect and spot patterns between your high productivity days, so you can reverse engineer the good days and avoid the things that cause the bad days. To add a new year to your habit tracker, just go to the year view and click on new. This will add a template button with a new year checklist containing step-by-step instructions along with a text and video guide showing you exactly what you need to do to set up a new year. But basically all you need to do is just go to your week's database at the bottom of the dashboard and add your previous year to each of the weeks. So week 1 becomes week 1 2023. The reason for doing this is we're going to add new weeks to our new year. And if you want to update your add week button inside of the days database, then you don't want to guess which is the correct week. After adding in the previous year to all of your weeks, you want to go back to your new year and click on the add quarters button. This will automatically create and link new quarters to your new year. Then you want to click inside of each quarter and click on the add months button to add new months to each of your quarters. And then you want to do this one more time inside of each month to add new weeks to that month. And then once your weeks are renamed and you've added new quarters, months and weeks to your new year, then you can go back to your day and edit the add weeks button and add in your new week 1. And because we've added the previous year to our previous weeks, this will be the one without the year next to it. Now the last part of our dashboard is the addiction tracker. On your addiction tracker callout box, you want to replace the word addiction with the bad habit you're struggling with the most and need to remove to improve your life. Once you've done that, you want to click on the view dropdown and select the third view. Then click inside of each week and add the dates for that week. Just click on the date property, select Monday, click on the end date toggle, and then select that Sunday. And just repeat this for all 12 weeks so that it has the date range of each week. Then if you go back to the first view, it'll show the week that you're currently in, and on the second view, it'll show the total monthly progress. Your goal with this addiction tracker is to simply start a streak and to not break it, and then each month to beat the previous month's score. And after the 12 weeks, you should be good, but you can always add more weeks and months if needed. And now this last part is going to be about the 6 individual templates included inside the page section of this dashboard. First up is the goal tracker. The first thing you want to do is click inside of each of the 4 pillars of life and then rate yourself out of 10. Then over time you just try to increase the score to a 10 out of 10. You also have a vision board on the right where you can add images of the life you're working towards. And then you have the goals section where you can create goals you want to achieve and link them to the 4 pillars. And then for each goal you can add multiple key results. Inside of the second view of the key results section, you can add a target for each key result and your current progress to get the total progress of that key result. And then the total progress of your key results will show up on the goal, and then the total progress of your goals will show up on the life pillar. The next one is very similar to the goal tracker but more focused around skills. At the top you have your character stats where you can add your total score out of 10 for each of them and then try to increase it over time. Then you have the skills section where you add all the skills you want to learn or master and the key results or progressions for each of them, which will then show as a total progress on each skill. The next page is for tracking your macros. Inside this meal planner, you have a shopping list page that you can add as a widget on your phone to quickly add new items to your shopping list using a button and then check them off when you're at the grocery store. Then you have callout boxes to define each of your macro targets, the macro tracker itself, a recipes database, and your ingredients database. Inside the ingredients database, you want to log all of the ingredients that you use on a regular basis and add in all of their macros. Then inside the recipes database, you can create recipes that you have often and use the macro calculator inside to determine the total macros for that recipe. And as for the macro tracker, you can create a new meal, open it up, and then find the macro calculator. Inside this database, you can select the ingredient that you used and add in the quantity of that ingredient. This will then add all the macros of your ingredients together, showing the totals at the bottom. And then all you do is just type in those totals into the database entry. And if you add one of the recipes, then you just type in that recipe's macros instead of doing this whole process for each recipe over again. And then on the macro tracker, you can see your total macros for each day. This next page is to plan out your workouts. On the workout plan database, you can click on the drop-down next to new and duplicate the default workout template button. Inside this new template button, you can give it a name and then define the type of workout you'll be doing for each day and then select the exercises for each. If you want to add in your own exercises, then you can find the exercises database at the bottom of the fitness planner. Then to add a new workout, you simply create a new database entry and select your template button. You can also log your weights and also plan your workouts in advance by using the date property and the calendar view. Then for this fitness planner, you also have a progress tracker where you can add in today's date and then select your start weight, target weight and your current weight to have the weight progress bar update. Note that this weight progress bar works for both weight gain as well as weight loss, and it will also work for both kilograms and pounds. Then on the second view, you can add in all your body measurements as well as a progress picture, which will show up on the gallery view, and then you also have a calendar. And if you want, you can also embed your workout playlist onto this page. Next up is the finance tracker. Inside of this page, you'll find a setup checklist with guides showing you exactly how to set up your finance tracker before you start using this template, which includes setting up the line chart and also linking your finance tracker to the overview database, which shows your total income, expenses, and profit for each year. In the finance tracker, you can log your income and expenses and link them to an income and expense source, as well as a bank account, which will update the total bank balance. And at the bottom, you have a subscription tracker to manage all of your monthly subscriptions. You can also add in all of your subscriptions into the monthly subscription button, so you can just click the button at the beginning or end of each month and instantly add all of your subscriptions as expenses to your finance tracker. I already have a full tutorial about this finance tracker, which will be linked in the card above. Then this last page is for adding all the books you still want to read or are currently reading. You can also open each page and add a book summary inside, and for each book you can also track your progress, add in the authors, add a genre, and also add in the link to the audiobook. And there you go, now you know how to use my Habit Tracker Hub. I truly hope that this dashboard will help you become more focused, more productive, and help you on your journey of reaching your fullest potential. If you haven't yet, be sure to grab this dashboard through the first link in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.